हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ रेखा चौहान, लेक्चरर GWPC जोधपुर, वेलकम यू ऑल टू टुडेज ई लेक्चर ऑन कलर एंड इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट डेफिनेशन ऑफ कलर्स एंड इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन। वी विल ऑल्सो सी द डिफरेंट स्कीम्स ऑफ कलर। वॉट इज कलर स्टूडेंट्स? कलर इज द एलिमेंट ऑफ आर्ट दैट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड व्हेन लाइट स्ट्राइकिंग एन ऑब्जेक्ट is reflected to the eye. The application of color is universal and also an emotional process. Color is an element of art that is enjoyed most depending on the ability to use it effectively and beautifully. Nature has amazing abundant varieties of colors in its bounty that artists and designers try to copy them, which to date is a challenge. Colors are a source of pleasure and families try to use beautiful colors in their home to bring in joy, cheerfulness, serenity and peace. Careful selection of furniture, furnishings, accessories and arranging them with utmost care for adequate space and appropriate colors make the homes more functionally comfortable and aesthetically beautiful. All individuals have natural ability to recognize beauty, but understanding and applying the element of art and principle of design will enhance the beauty and functionalism, a characteristic of the modern homes. To understand and use of color, we need to know the language of color and its characteristics. Students, the colors are classified as follows. They are classified as primary colors, secondary or binary colors, and tertiary colors. So, primary colors are the three main colors that are foundation for all other colors. All colors may be obtained by mixing in various proportion of three fundamental hues. That is red, yellow and blue. These are called the three primary colors because they are the basic elements in the use of pigment. They are the only use in pigment that cannot be obtained by mixing other hues. When two primary colors are mixed in equal amounts, a different hue will result. This new hue is called a binary or secondary color. When we mix red with blue color, we get a violet color. When we mix primary blue and yellow color, we obtain a new hue, that is green color. When we mix red primary with yellow primary, we obtain a secondary color orange. So, in this way, when we mix the primary colors, then we get three secondary colors, that is green, orange and violet. So, in this way, when we mix the primary colors, then we get three secondary colors, that is green, orange and violet. When a primary and a neighboring binary are mixed, the resultant is an intermediate hue. In appearance, the intermediate hue is halfway between the two colors. There are six of these intermediate hues: yellow green, blue green, blue purple, red violet, red orange and yellow orange. So, when we place these primary, secondary and intermediate colors on a circle, we get our color wheel. Now, when two binary colors are mixed, we get a tertiary colors. These tertiary colors are yellow, blue and red, which are very neutral, very dull in color, and so we get smoky yellow. Blue is known as slate blue and tertiary red is the color of old red brick. So we see that by placing these all colors on a circle, we obtain a color wheel based on red, yellow and blue. Sir Isaac Newton developed the first circular diagram. In a color wheel, colors from red violet to yellow are known as warm colors. In a color wheel, colors from violet to yellow green are called cool colors. Colors have a strong effect on our emotions. Cool colors have a quietening influence. On the other hand, warm colors have a cheerful effect, which may increase stimulation and excitement. Color, because of its emotional effect, is largely responsible for atmosphere in the home. It is capable of smoothing or irritating or cheering, welcoming or repelling, charming or boring. For example, yellow has the effect of cheerful gaiety, optimism in the home. It gives the effect of sunlight. Similarly, blue is associated with water and sky, giving a cool effect. So these effects all are due to the fact that the eyes adjust when focusing on the colors of different wavelength. Red light have longer wavelength than blue ones. Our eyes get fatigued faster by seeing red colors as compared to blue colors. So we see that warm tones like red, orange and yellow can energize a space and its occupants. Cool tones such as blue, green and purple generally create a quite relaxing atmosphere. When choosing wall and flooring colors, it's important to keep the goal of the space in mind. If energetic work is being performed in a space, warm, exhilarating tones might be good to consider. In break areas, cool tones may be more appropriate when occupants can relax. Warm colors are advancing colors, visually reduce the size of the room and make a room seem smaller, while cool colors are receding colors which make a room seem larger. We can use the different colors on color wheel to create different effects in our interior designings. Here we will be discussing about the complementary color scheme. What is a complementary color scheme? The colors that are opposite to each other on a color wheel are known as to be complementary colors. The high contrast of complementary color creates a vibrant look, especially when used at full saturation. It is based on two colors found opposite to each other in the color wheel. These colors need not necessarily be used in their pure form, and they can be used in many values or intensities to have variety. Vividly, the different six color schemes are, we can use as is yellow with purple, red with green, blue with orange, yellow green and red purple, blue green with red orange, blue purple with yellow orange. So a complementary color scheme is a stimulating, vivid and bright scheme. It provides a combination of both warm and cool colors, thereby results in a balanced combination. Between the two colors, one can be subdued and the other dominating. Normally, a cool color is used in larger quantity or in larger areas as compared to the warmer one to have a balanced effect. Complementary color scheme is highly suitable in such an area like living area, nursery, teenagers and children's and drawing rooms. This color scheme may not be suitable in a dining room to avoid the attention detracting from the food, more so when the room is a small one. When used in a large room, they can be suitably mixed with a few neutral colors to avoid that extra stimulating effect or the vibrant effect of the contrasting colors. So this color scheme must be managed well. Complementary color scheme may be the most pleasing or they may be least satisfactory depending upon how they are used. All right, I'd like to show you all a cool optical illusion. If you are struggling with a complementary colors, your eyes can tell you which you to go together. How does that work? In a moment, I am going to skip to the next slide and I want you all to stare at the color that you see for about 15 seconds. Then I'll change the slide again. You all can tell me what color you see next. Are you ready? Students, stare the yellow color for 15 seconds. So, what color do you see in the circle? Obviously, you must be seeing an after image of violet color inside the circle. Analogous colors are the colors that are next to each other on the color wheel. They often share a base color like yellow or red. Analogous colors look good next to each other because they share similarities in appearance. Designers often use analogous colors combination to create work that are attractive to eye. Analogous color scheme is one that combines colors that are adjacent to one another in color wheel. It generally uses one color as its major force with the two neighboring colors to enhance it. Example, yellow with yellow green and green, or blue with blue green and blue purple. Any adjacent colors may be used in combination with interesting effects. Analogous color scheme is much more interesting than a monochromatic color scheme. It is also a simple and easy scheme to choose and adopt even for an inexperienced person. Adjacent color scheme can be used in any room irrespective of its size. It is suitable for both small and large rooms. The colors lying adjacent to each other in a color wheel is to be learned. One can choose either all warm or all cool colors. For example, a combination of yellow, yellow orange, orange and red orange makes up a warm analogous color scheme. A combination of blue-purple, blue, blue-green and green provides a cool analogous color scheme. A combination of both warm and cool color scheme also possible in an analogous scheme by choosing colors of blue-green, green, yellow-green and yellow or blue-purple, purple, red-purple and red. So analogous harmonies are quite restful and show more variety than one hue harmonies. The point to be kept in mind is that the lighter colors and their tints to be used at the higher level, mid values at mid level and the darker values at the lower level. This picture is made by an artist, Vincent van Gogh. He used an analogous color scheme to paint this picture of sunflowers. He used orange, yellow, yellow orange and yellow green as well as tints and shade of those colors to create a visually appealing painting. The split triad or split complementary color scheme is a variation of the complementary color scheme. In addition to the base color, it uses the two colors adjacent to its complement. This scheme has the same strong visual contrast as the complementary color scheme but has less tension. The split complementary color scheme is often a good choice for beginners because it is difficult to mess up. Combining one color with two colors on either side of its direct complements result in the split complementary color harmony. For example, yellow combined with blue violet and red violet. Following combination also work, like yellow with blue purple and red purple, yellow green with purple and red, green with red purple and red orange, blue green with red and red orange. This harmony provides a softer contrast than a direct complement. It is harmony of similar colors with a note of contrasting colors and hence make a lively and stimulating color scheme. The warm hues in combination with the cool hues need careful handling because of their strong and advancing effects. When executed properly, this color harmony may produce pleasing effect. This painting is using a split triad scheme which is very pleasing to the eye. Tints are the colors that are created using any color from the color wheel and white. Tints can range from dark to light depending upon how much white they have in them. Shades are colors that are created using any color from the color wheel and black. Shades are generally much darker than tints. A monochromatic color scheme is the simplest scheme that can be used in our interior. Monochromatic colors can be created by mixing a color from a color wheel with varying amount of white and black. This is a beautiful example of a monochromatic color scheme. Monochromatic color scheme is the simplest of all schemes to use because they are based on only one hue. A careful thought and a complete analysis of a room in terms of its use, exposure, size, etc. is necessary for deciding the single color to be used in any room. This scheme, when more of the tints of colors are used, helps to give a spacious feeling to an interior and provides unity for a composition and a quiet background for objects and people within it. The scheme also offers designer reasonable chances of success. The only drawback is that being a single color, it is easily become boring and therefore is seldom used in its true form. The key success to provide enough contrast through pattern, texture, furniture, shape, etc. So friends, it was fun with talking with you and hope you enjoyed the presentation of color. Thank you.